Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with a very important topic, that is cashless society. Now in this topic we will broadly be dealing with the two issues. The first one is why people don't pay taxes, and the second is why cashlessness is a mirage. Now first of all, we need to understand why this cashless society, it has become a kind of a preaching from the government. Why the government is preaching this cashlessness? Why government wants to create a cashless society? What good it will do to our society? Now before we understand this cashless society, we need to understand something called as black money. Black money, and then we also need to understand what is white money, and then we also really need to understand is black money really black. This is a kind of a question that I am putting forward. Now, is black money really black, white money and black money? Now, what is meant by black money? According to government, any kind of income that is generated in the economy, and once it has been generated, it is not causing any benefit to the government. Though the income has been generated, but the government is not gaining out of it. Not gaining out of it means government is not able to assess that new generated income, and because it is not able to assess that new generated income, it is not able to extract tax from that very income. Income generate hui hai, income generation ka sarkar ko pata nahi chala hai, it has remained concealed from the government, and because it was concealed, no tax could be levied on that income, and government's collections basically go down. And according to government, this is one of the reasons of why we have very less tax to GDP ratio. Ye tax to GDP jo ratio hai, itna zyada kam kyun hai? This is one of the reasons according to the government. Black money is the reason. This is how black money is defined. And how do we define white money? Now, white money is that money on which the taxes are paid. White money is that money which is generated not in a concealed manner, but which is generated openly. Now, when it is generated openly, government can levy taxes on it. Government can extract taxes from it. And this is what enhances the government's income. So, government wants people to earn by the means of white money. That is, they should not be concealing their sources or resources of earning. Very, very important. Now, this is how this money is defined. But there is a question that I am asking, is black money really black? Now, this is a kind of a debate. Now, how do we define black money? Black money on which the taxes are not paid. But when a black money is earned, suppose I have earned some black money from some X resource. The once I have earned it, I will be using that very black money to avail some kind of service, availing services from a saloon, availing services from by traveling, availing services by buying gadgets, availing services by buying some luxury cars. Now, if I will be buying all these things, I will be paying indirect taxes, because it is very, very difficult to buy a car without paying sales tax on it, without paying registration duty on it. So the money that I have generated, that is the black money has been generated, and I have just not paid one tax on it, that is direct tax. But rest of the taxes I will have to pay if I want the circulation of the black money to take place. And without circulation, if I will not be circulating that money will be useless for me. That money will not have any use for me. So, when a circulation of the money is done, it changes its color. From black, it actually becomes gray. Now, why gray? Because a part of the taxes are paid in the form of indirect taxes. So, what money was earned in a concealed manner is spent openly in the market. And the market, by spending openly in the market, I tend to pay indirect taxes. So, this is black money is actually not very black. Now, why people conceal their money, conceal their earnings? Now, this year's economic survey has done a very important study. Now, according to this year's economic survey, the proportionate, the tax collection of any country is directly proportionate to the kind of the legitimacy, to the kind of the belief, to the kind of the trust they impose in their government. So basically it is the legitimacy of the government. Kitna agar aap apni sarkar ko jyada jaiz mante ho, us case mein aap apni sarkar ko jyada paise doge. Agar aap apni sarkar mein jyada trust karte ho, agar aapko vishwas hai ki jo aap paise de rahe ho, unse kuch tangible cheezein banengi jisse aapko fayda hoga, intangible cheezein unleash hongi market mein, usse aapko fayda hoga, tabhi aap taxes doge. अगर आपको पता है कि आप टैक्सेस दे रहे हो और गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट एफिशिएंट, गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट इफेक्टिव, गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट सेटिंग हॉस्पिटल्स, गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट सेटिंग कॉलेजेस, गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग यू गुड रोड्स, गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट प्रोवाइडिंग यू एनी काइंड ऑफ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर और एनी काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट, इन दैट केस यू विल नॉट बी पेइंग द टैक्सेस. सो दिस ईयर्स इकोनॉमिक सर्वे हैज कम आउट विद अ डायरेक्ट रिलेशनशिप between the tax collection and the trust that the people imposes in their government. Less the trust, less will be the tax collection. So the government really needs to enhance their credibility. The key word here is credibility. If the credibility will be less, the tax collection will be less. Now the second is, why cashlessness is a mirage? Now, why cashlessness? Like, in the first part of the lecture, I have talked about black money. I have told that this black money is earned in a concealed manner. The manner is very concealed. The manner is secret. You don't show it, you don't exhibit your way of earning. You actually are tending to conceal it. And by concealing it, you are not making your income liable to be taxed. But by way of cashlessness, अगर आपको कोई भी चीज खरीदनी है, you have to use the digital money, you have to use the plastic money by way of debit card, the credit card, the net banking. Now why this has been introduced? Now cashlessness means that this concealing aspect will go. Government wants transparency because this transparency, government believes that this will help in increasing tax to GDP ratio. And this is something that is very true. This is something that will create a very substantive effect. But why have I written why cashlessness is a mirage? It is a mirage because in India, the people are very poor. The people, they don't have access to internet. People don't have access to mobile. People don't have access to banking facilities. So, let us suppose it is only the 20% of the people, top 20% of the people in the economy, as per their per capita income, they change their way of transaction to cashlessness. But the bottom 80% will not be able to have access to this cashlessness thing. In that case, if these 80% will be interacting with this 20% to avail some kind of services from them. अगर किसी गरीब ने किसी अस्पताल में जाके इलाज कराना है, अगर किसी गरीब ने मेडिकल शॉप के पास जाके दवाइयां लेनी है, अगर किसी गरीब ने ट्रेवल करना है रेलवे में, अगर किसी गरीब ने रोडवेज से ट्रेवल करना है, इन दैट केस ही और शी विल नॉट बी एबल टू ट्रांसफर मनी डिजिटली बिकॉज ऑफ पॉवर्टी, बिकॉज ऑफ इलिटरेसी, बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ एक्सेस टू रिसोर्सेज, बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस, बिकॉज ऑफ लैक ऑफ एम्पावरमेंट. इन दैट केस it is the hospital owner, it is the owner of the transportation company, it is the owner of the chemist shop who will be gaining in the form of cash, who will be gaining in the form of cash, and this transaction will again remain concealed. So cashlessness means transparency. But this is not possible. First of all, we need to reduce the disparity. First of all, we need to create conditions. You cannot plant trees in air. You need to provide soil. You need to provide some base. You need to provide some kind of foundation. Only then we can introduce such substantive things. Now, why this is a mirage? In January 2015, the total amount of spendings done by the way of plastic money, it was around 32,000 crore rupees, and in January 2016 it was just rupees 33,000 crore rupees, and in September 2016, before demonetization, it was around 46,000 crore rupees. And after demonetization in the month of November and December, it is just 32,000 rupees. There has not been any substantive change. So you need to alter the behavior of the people. So this is the kind of the culture that the people are really finding it difficult to adopt. This is something that we are doing exogenously. This is something that we are not able to do it from within. Andar se change nahi leke aa pa rahe. So the kind of a question that can be asked from this topic is like, critically analyze cashlessness economy in restricting corruption. You must give this example. Example of disparity in it. Another question that can be asked, is India really ready for being or going cashless? This can be asked. Now, another question that can be asked, what is the difference between black money and white money? Now, will this cashlessness arrest this black money or not? So, this was all for the day. Now, if you want to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. If you want to read in the form of a brainy map, again, you can visit brainyias.com. So, this was all for the day. Baba, take care. Have a nice night.